When exposed to seawater, steel forms a compact surface film that protects it from dissolution. Marine-grade steel is specially designed to resist corrosion in harsh, salty ocean. So, why does it corrode? Well, what we didn't consider until recently are those tiny little creatures invisible to our eyes, microorganisms. Their excellent survival mechanisms enable them to adapt or even create new environments. Long enough, we thought that the deposition of metabolites is the main reason the protective film of steel breaks in the presence of bacteria, but the groundbreaking theory of extracellular electron transfer found that without their usual source of energy, some microorganisms are able to grow on metal surface, form biofilm that draws electrons directly from metal and use those electrons for their own metabolism. So, what does this really mean? Well, steel is mostly made of iron, and one could say microorganisms are spending the iron. Because the protective film is being destroyed, iron can leave the crystal structure of the steel. You see, biocorrosion causes security accidents, which lead to serious economic losses, and it is a growing global problem. So, how do we stop or inhibit these interesting chemical reactions on the steel surface? The most commonly used method for protection is the use of biocides, highly effective and relatively cheap. But unfortunately, they're harmful to other organisms and influence the physiochemical equilibrium of the ocean that we desperately want to preserve. That's why my mentors and I believe there's a greener approach to this problem. The main focus of our research is how Artemisia annua, in the presence of bacterium Pseudomonas aeruginosa, influenced the film formation of alloys used in the shipbuilding industry. We're using advanced electrochemical, optical and surface techniques to learn about chemical reactions that occur during biocorrosion. Artemisia annua, or sweet wormwood, is a wildflower that exhibits excellent antioxidative and antibacterial properties. Valuable compounds found in the extract can spontaneously adsorb on the steel surface, improve the structure of protective film that inhibits bacterial growth, which then prolongs the durability of the material. We hope that this wildflower, that is known for thousands of years and grows naturally in our region, will be used as a raw, renewable material for the design and production of environmentally friendly biocorrosion inhibitors and help us respond to the challenges of both growing environmental and economic global problems.